Okay, section 5.4, special factoring. So basically, this section is referring us back to chapter 4 when we had the special products. And so we're going to look at three different kinds of special factoring here. So I'm going to go through them one at a time. You can see I already have one example up and that I'm going to do. But so I just kind of want to remind us, and again, we're going to do this one at a time. So here's our first one. In chapter 4, we learned that if you have a binomial and you square it, that it fits this pattern when you multiply it out, right? A plus b squared is equal to a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. So here, since we're factoring, we're going to be doing this process in reverse. And so what's nice about these is you could, so here's my example, 9x squared plus 48x plus 64. You could factor this exactly the same way that we did the stuff back in section 5.3. Having said that, there are some clues here that we have that this is going to fit one of these pat this pattern that we have, and that's going to make our lives quite a lot easier if we can recognize it. In particular, what I'm looking for is that the beginning and end are both squares. Okay, so we're working with this pattern. If we can determine that both the beginning and the end are squares, then it's going to factor very nicely just to be those two different pieces are added together and squared. All right, so maybe that sounds a little weird. Let's take a look at what we actually have. So let's look at the 9x squared. When I see 9, I'm thinking, hey, that's 3 to the second power. So my a would be the same as 3x here because that's what is really being squared in that first spot. 64 is 8 to the second power. So my b would be 8. And so it looks like I have this pattern because I have squares at the beginning and squares at the end. Now, those two things being squares is not foolproof. It does not necessarily mean we have the pattern. We do here, but it doesn't necessarily mean it. So we do actually have to kind of check it all out and make sure that it works. So what we're saying is that 9x squared is the same as 3x to the second, and that's what we're calling a. We're saying that 8 to the second is 64, and that's what we were calling our b. And notice in the middle here, we need 48x to equal 2 times a times b. So I'm basically just taking my candidates for a and b, the 3x and the 8, multiplying it all together with this extra 2 that is coming out of that special product pattern that we had. And sure enough, 2 times 3 is 6. 6 times 8 is 48. So this works. And here's why it's really, really nice. If it works, you're done. Here's why. We know A is the 3x. We know B is just the 8. And the pattern says, if you know what those are, it's just 3x plus 8 squared. And that's it. So these are really nice. The second pattern we're going to look at here in just a second is almost exactly the same, and so it'll give us a great chance to do a second example. The only difference is we're going to put a minus sign in the middle, and otherwise it'll be exactly the same and the same process to figure it out. So let's go ahead and do that next. All right, so here's our second pattern. Remember I said there were going to be three, so here's our second one. Notice I basically got to leave the whole top of the board alone because the only thing that changed is we have a minus sign now. Okay, so our factoring is going to have a minus sign in it, which you can see in the answer I have over there for this example. And the key that tells us that we have this pattern instead of the other one is that we have a minus sign in the middle. Okay, so hopefully we can all see that minus sign. I think we can. And so here's my example, 49x squared minus 28xy. Uh-oh, I threw another letter in there. That's going to be weird. Plus 4y squared. Please note, it's only the one minus sign. They're not both minus signs, just this one. So again, I have the same kind of tip-off that I had before. Okay, I have 49 here at the beginning. 49 is just screaming at me, hey, I am 7 to the second power. And at the end, I have 4. 4 is telling me 2 to the second power. And so right away, I have candidates for A and B. A, I think, should be 7x because if I square that, I get 49x squared. And B, the y is a little bit weird, but it's not really. It's just more of the same kind of thing. B is 2y. because again, 2 squared is 4, so if we square 2y, we get 4y. So it looks like we have a really good candidate here to use this pattern, right? We have the minus sign, we have squares at either end, and now we just have to just check the middle real quick and make sure it works. Because we do have this extra 2, just like with the last one, and so we have to check what 2 times a times b is. So I am checking the extra 2 times my a, which is 7x, times my b, which is 2y. And if I multiply all that out, I do get 28xy. 2 times 7 is 14, times 2 is 28. So it works. We're looking for those squares at either end. If we have that, it's worth checking because then it's super easy. Because now, since I know what a is and I know what b is, it's just a minus b squared. And that's the second pattern. All right, we have one more pattern to look at here in section 4. This is what's called a difference of squares, which I probably should have written on the board, but I didn't. So if you remember back in chapter 4, we had this particular pattern. A plus b times a minus b. So 2 sets of parentheses, same 2 things on the inside, but one was positive and one was negative. And when we multiplied, all the middle terms fell out, and we just got a squared minus b squared. So these are my favorite patterns to work with because if we look at, say, this example here, x squared minus 100, there is no middle term to worry about. All we have to do is say, is this something to the second power? It is. It's x, right? X to the second power is x squared. Is 100 something to the second power? Yep. 100 is 10 to the second power. So I know, because, and it has to be a minus sign. If this is a plus sign, this will never work. But I know that since I have squares in both spots, it's just the first thing plus the second thing times the first thing minus the second thing. Done. Those are my favorite because they go really, really quick. Here's another one. This one's a bit more complicated. We have 16x squared minus 25y squared. Okay, so again, I'm looking for squares. I know that 16 is 4 to the second power, so I think my first one is 4x. Sure looks like it. 25 is 5 to the second power, so my second piece is 5y. We have squares for both of them. First thing plus the second thing. First thing minus the second thing. Look how nice that is, right? A plus B, A minus B. This is the nicest factoring you'll ever do, in my humble opinion. All right, I do have one last thing I want to throw in here real fast. Just a reminder, any problem can have a greatest common factor. Okay, so back in section 1, we talked about finding a greatest common factor and always making sure that you look for that first. So none of these examples had a greatest common factor, but sometimes they will. And if you can see that and get it out of the way, then maybe you get something a lot easier. Well, you certainly get something easier that's left. So there you go.